Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Swati, consulting cosmetic dental surgeon working with Partha Dental, Uttarali branch. Let me share you the location of our clinic. Our clinic is located opposite to Brigade Residency Apartments in Chikkalsilla. It's very close to Chikkalsilla main bus stop. It's there on first floor. In today's topic, I would like to share an important information regarding bleeding gums. Bleeding gums are the classic signs of infection in the gums. Otherwise, in normal and healthy conditions, your gums should be in coral pink color and they have to be firm. In case of infection in the gums, your gums will become red in color and they will be swollen. When you try to brush these swollen gums, they eventually bleed. Now coming to the causes of bleeding gums, in 80% of the cases, bleeding gums are caused by plaque and development of plaque and tartar deposits on the tooth surface. These deposits are yellow to dark brown in color and they harbor millions of bacteria. And in other 20% of the cases, bleeding gums are caused by systemic conditions such as leukemia, a type of blood cancer, bleeding disorders and hormonal changes in your body. And also if you have any deficiency of vitamins like vitamin D, vitamin K and vitamin C. In today's topic, I would like to emphasize more on local factors associated with bleeding gums. What happens when we don't treat this condition is that most often bleeding gums are not painful, and you should not ignore this problem just because you don't have any pain in the gums. Because if we ignore this problem, the infection in the gums can spread to the attachment tissue and also to the gum, to the bones that are present in between the teeth. And when this happens, you may lose your teeth at early stage. So what are the other symptoms associated with infection in the gums along with bleeding gums are bad breath and development of gaps in between the teeth, residing gums and mobility. So how can we treat this bleeding gums problem is that, and first of all, you have to visit a dentist in once in 3 to 6 months to make sure everything is perfect. You have to get the regular dental checkups done. After screening your teeth, if we find any dark yellow brown deposits on the tooth surface, we would be advising you to undergo regular tooth cleaning done. Depending upon the severity of the infection in the gums, we may advise you to undergo small gum surgery to prevent the progression of the disease. So, visiting a dentist in every 3 to 6 months is very important to prevent the further loss of tooth. And also, if you have any bleeding gums problem, instead of changing the toothpaste at home, you have to visit a dentist and get the regular checkups done, because you cannot remove these hard deposits no matter how hard you brush. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. This is Dr. Swati signing off.